Hey everybody, I am at Goshen, Indiana for MRF 2021, and it is hot and humid in this building, but I found Joe from Project R3D. How you doing, Joe?
Doing well. How are you doing?
Man, I'm doing great. I am so pumped about your new project. First of all, tell us who you are and what you're doing, and then we'll get into that.
Yeah, like I said, I'm Joe from Project Red. We are here in Indiana. We manufacture the Daedalus 3D printers right now. What we wanted to make is there was a bunch of project printers that were doing really cool things, and we had worked on those projects in the past, and we decided that it was time to make a fully ready to go out of the box experience for all these awesome things. In the past, a bunch of 3D printer companies, they were doing baby steps. And all these projects made these giant leaps in what to do next. So what we figured out was we could put all those into one system, out of the box, ready to go in about 15 minutes.
Nice. Yes. That's awesome. And for those of you at home, if you check out Joel Telling's channel, the 3D printing nerd, he actually got one of these, and it's called Daedalus, right?
It's called the Daedalus.
Daedalus. Okay, so it's Daedalus, not Daedalus, not Daedalus, or anything like that. It's Daedalus. So we have one printing over here. Tell us what's special about this printer. I mean, what makes it the Daedalus?
So what is really special about it is ready to print out of the box at 100 to 150 millimeters a second.
Man, that's awesome.
Like, you got the Volrons, you got the Railcores. They're great printers, great projects, and they can do amazing speeds, but you have to build them. You're looking at like 20 hours of build time. Some people just don't have that.
Right.
So what we're doing is it's all linear rail, three lead screw bed alignment.
Ooh.
Like, we're actually tramming the bed.
All right.
We're using, we used to use the BL touches. We got rid of them. The moving part is always the failure point. The pin would break.
Right.
So we moved over to the TH3D Easy ABL.
I like it. All right.
So we can print on anything.
Nice.
And so we had no problems there. We could do glasses and PEIs, everything.
Nice.
But right now it's printing the Gargoyle from Chaos Cortec,
okay.
Chelsea and Garrett.
Right.
It's a beautiful model. You're getting a little bit of stringing today from the humidity.
Yeah, it's humid in here.
But the exterior walls are printing at 100 millimeters a second, infills at 150. And that's standard.
And we'll get some close-up shots, because you guys see this thing is cruising. Not only that, it is solidly built. And this is the production model currently, right?
Yes.
And it you know, it's enclosed. It has a nice acrylic on the outside.
Yes.
All the electronics are behind inside, right?
It's running a Duet 3 Raspberry Pi.
Okay.
So the cool thing is Duet's been doing some crazy updates to their firmware. So we're doing all the plug-ins. You can plug a camera into it right now.
Nice.
And it'll just come up on the web interface.
And you got the touch screen in the front.
The touch screen. Yeah. The MagBed upgrade options.
Nice. And the cool thing about this is it kind of shows off that you don't have to be a huge company to do something like this.
No.
You guys aren't a huge company.
No, we're not huge.
You guys have day jobs and everything else.
But you
do this too.
For the most part, most of us are moved to full time just because of the throughput.
Because of the production. Yeah.
We can't keep up. Right.
That's
now,
a great thing.
That's a good thing. Right now, we have like a 2-week lead time.
And parts are hard, right? Right now?
Parts are hard.
Okay.
But we've been able to secure enough for the rest of the year, which is
nice.
That's
awesome.
Right now, aluminum extrusion is the crazy thing.
So with better build quality and all these things comes probably a higher price than we are normally used to seeing with our Creality machines, right?
Yeah.
So where's this start?
So our normal price is $29.
Okay.
$2,900. But it's ready to go if you were to build what we used to do was the Railcore.
Yeah, right.
And if you were to buy all the stuff for the Railcore, we wanted to be competitive with our old products.
Sure.
So if you were to buy one of our old Railcore kits with all the stuff that this has, so there's no motion components, there's no functional parts of this printer that are printed. So the fan shroud, a couple spacers and stuff like that, it's SLS nylon.
Oh, okay.
So we wanted to stay in like a competitive price point
with that stuff.
So if you were gonna get like all of like the upgrades for like the yokes and all the metal stuff for like our old Railcore kits, you were looking at like $2,200 to $2,400.
Okay.
But then you had 13 to 25 hours of build time.
Yeah, yeah.
So we wanted to still help those people out we were helping before.
Nice.
And stay in that price point.
That's awesome. And it's really cool that these come ready to go and built. And you get to learn about three-point actual tramming when you get it, right?
Yes.
So something that I think it's like a Murph exclusive, right?
Yes.
Over here,
yes.
If we kind of cruise this way, this is not production yet, right? This is not in production, but this is going to be coming out sometime soon. What is up with this? This is awesome. So I guess I should ask, what's the build volume here?
So that is 310 by 300 by 345.
Okay.
This is going to be 310 by 300 by 650.
650, I love it.
So the big thing that we left all the panels off of this because we wanted people to see like what happens when you build a big printer. You can't just be like, I'm going to make the Z like extrusions taller.
Right.
You have to make it more rigid. So everything's hard mounted. There's no brackets like holding the main frame together. It's all tapped and then screwed together.
Okay.
And we're using 2040 on everything except for this top rail here, which is because of the cable chain and the Z uprights.
Okay.
Everything else is 2040. And then if you look at it, this is laid flat here, and then everything else is staggered a different direction. Because if you stagger it, it's sturdier. You're not gonna get the wiggle or the racking.
Okay, cool.
So you can jump up and down on this frame, and you're not gonna have a problem. The frame itself, with the panels, and just the Z axis, we're looking at about 60 pounds. We're anticipating it being well over 100 pounds.
That's awesome.
And yeah, it's a big boy. We do have enclosures coming for both. So the same top enclosure will work for both, but we have a different door.
That's awesome. Well, that's cool. That's coming soon, right?
Yes.
Maybe late this year, next year?
No. We're looking at in a couple months for this.
Oh, wow. A couple months.
Because it's the same thing.
I heard you need a beta tester. So I'll just take this home with me. I'll let you know.
This is actually going to Joe Spanier. He's going to be printing airplane parts.
Nice.
Because he's doing model airplane stuff and then speaker boxes,
from,
I guess.
From flight test, I believe. Yeah.
Yeah. So he's doing that. And then the big thing in this is the shipping is going to be different.
The shipping.
You got to do a wood crate, sadly.
Well, I'll come down and pick it up. That'll get rid of the shipping. You know?
But that's we're looking at $4,500 for these.
Oh, that's not bad. And that's a huge, solid printer.
Yeah.
So, awesome. Anything else that we can talk about? Looks like you have a
We have $200 off the standard data list, the only thing that's available right now. $200 off for the Murph. There's no coupon code or anything like that. So
just to let you know.
We're going to be doing that for probably the next week to 2 weeks.
Cool.
We haven't decided a firm end date. We'll know that by Monday.
Awesome.
Mainly by how many we still have left.
Well, Joe, I tell you, Things brought us here. So thanks so much to Things for bringing us here. I'm hoping that we can get I think this model is on Things, isn't it?
It may be.
The Chaos Cortec model. I'll have to look on Things because this model actually might be on their site now. But then, and also, Green Gate 3D is right down over here, and thank you guys so much for sponsoring the videos. We definitely appreciate that. But Joe, thank you. Thank you for taking the time. I appreciate it. It was good to see you.
Good to see you as well.
I can't wait to hang out for the rest of the day and see, these things print. So have a good one.